one would think with how obvious the footage of the murder of George Floyd was that you couldn't really be like shocked that it was declared murder by a judge. You should be pleased that the system actually worked, especially for many right wingers who say that they're law and order. Like, this is how the system is supposed to work, but they're really like mad yesterday. I'm not gonna show you Shapiro's tweets, but he was like really like snippy in that pathetic way that he can be. Yeah. Like, he's really mad that things didn't work out the way he wanted. But I'm not gonna show it because I can't take it right now. But we do have Tomi Lahren, who tweeted a couple of really like, I can't say the word, but it starts with S and ends with itty. Really like those sort of comments, you know? So she tweeted, "Is the Foot Locker safe tonight? Should be, right? Justice, right? No need to steal the name of George Floyd anymore, right? You got your justice. So you got your no, we got our justice. A murderer is going to jail. You should be happy about that, but you're not. It's weird, but that's a problem for you to deal with. So there should be peace in Minneapolis tonight. No rioting, no looting, no harassing officers." Well, okay. There wasn't rioting and looting. So are you gonna do a follow-up to that? Like, you were sort of saying, you're still gonna do it, aren't you? But no, yep. Nobody did that. So have you learned as a result of that? You certainly aren't saying anything as a result of that. That's weird, JR.
It's an odd thing. No, actually it's not. So the Foot Locker reference, and then you're gonna do it anyway. Mm-hmm. This is keeping the foot on the gas for the generalizations about the folks that they've been telling their supporters to hate. So no matter what happens, no matter how open and blatant this is, no matter how obviously easy this conviction was, they still have to go back at the end and paint the folks that are in favor of what just of the guilty verdict as looters and rioters, mm-hmm, and Foot Locker break in two people. So what picture comes in your head when you say the Foot Locker is still, mm-hmm, safe? Hey, they're gonna go out there and be violent anyway. All that stuff is to make sure that it's still kept in the back of the MAGA's heads. Hey, but those folks, they always riot. Even when it doesn't happen, they always riot. Just like they're always stealing. You know, if they come in the store, if their hands are in their pockets, they must have something in it. If they're confronted by police, they must have a gun. Hey, if I confront them and I use any kind of force on them, they must be superhuman. They must be up to something. They must have some drugs on them. They must have broken the law at some point. Let's pull them over anyway. All of those things go into the psyche for why we have these types of confrontations. You think police officers don't watch Fox News? You think police officers don't listen to Tomi Lahren? You think they're not on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook listening to the racist, rabid rhetoric that's happening? Yep. It fuels them. Police officers are just other members of society, then clock in and put a gun on their hip and have the authority to then carry out their biases. They're not some random robots that are put in this position to then carry out justice in the streets. They're humans in this country that is seriously racially divided and gives credence to racists. It does. It's always given support and it's given comfort to racists. So if you are one and we've given you a job where you get to hold a gun on your hip and carry out your biases, we allow it to happen. That's the way we've always run this. They're just other humans. So you think people like Tomi Lahren then continuing to say, well, did they riot tonight? Where's the Foot Locker at? You think cops and people in authority of all positions, from judges and prosecutors and defense attorneys, all that, aren't hearing that? And many of them agree with her? They do. They do. And these are the people that we're trusting our justice system with to carry out justice for real people. That's why it hasn't worked.
Or maybe it's just a few bad apples. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.